So here we are going to solve a problem of a simple conduction inside Ansys, wherein one surface of the block is at a temperature of 500 degrees centigrade and all other sides are at a temperature of 100 degrees centigrade, and the thermal conductivity for this particular material is 10 watts per meter centigrade, and you know the block is assumed to be infinitely long. So we are going to apply all these boundary conditions inside Ansys and find out the temperature distribution inside the block for the given thermal conductivity. So I have opened Ansys APDL product launcher and I have given the job name as simple conduction and I click on run. So once I click on run, the Ansys APDL opens and I go to preferences. As this is a thermal problem, I need to select my preference as thermal and press OK, and then go to the preprocessor, element type, add, edit, delete, add, and it is a thermal mass wherein we are going to take a solid. So select the under thermal mass, select the solid and select the quad 4 node 55 element and press OK and close this one. Then go to the material properties, material models, go to thermal. Just you need to enter only the conductivity. It is enough for this particular problem. So conductivity, and as it is an isotropic material, I will select isotropic and I need to enter the value as 10. Remember, the units are watts per meter centigrade. That means whatever length units you are going to give, it will be in meters. Whatever the temperature you will get results, that will be in degrees centigrade. Okay, then go to the material and say exit. Now go to modeling, go to create areas, rectangle by two corners, and here the starting points should be from the origin. So I will enter, type in 0 and 0, and the width of the particular this one is width and height of the particular rectangular area is 1 meter by 1 meter. So I've entered 1 and 1 and press OK. So we have created the required area. So once we created the required area, we should be meshing it. So I go to the meshing, mesh tool. Here in, as this is a area, we need to select this area set and say pick all, and then we need to give the element edge length. Let us give it as 0.05 and press OK. Then go to raise hidden, say mesh, and select this area and mesh this particular area, and now say raise hidden and you just close this tool. Then once we have done meshing, we need to apply the boundary conditions. So I need to go to the loads, in the loads define loads, and that apply thermal temperature on nodes. And now I am going to change the type of selection from single to box, so that I can draw a box around whatever required elements or entities I need, so that everything will be selected in a single row, single time. So I will select the nodes, I will draw the box around the top nodes and press apply, OK. Then I will give the temperature as 500 value and I say apply, and then I pick up the side nodes, select the side nodes and press OK, and I will give the temperature of 100 and I say apply. Then again I will select this particular nodes on this side, press OK, and give the temperature of 100, and then I am going to select the box, and so I have selected this one. So once I selected this one, press OK and apply a temperature of 100 degrees. So we have applied all the boundary conditions. Now go to the solution, say solve current load step and press OK, and the solution is done. Now what you will do is go to the general go to the general post processing and go to the plot results and go to contour plot, nodal solution, UAF solution and nodal temperature, because we are going to find out the temperature distribution inside this particular body or block. Say okay, so here the distribution is like this, and as we know the maximum temperature should be 500, that is what we have already given in the boundary conditions, and the minimum temperature is 100. Here in this contour plot you can see the distribution of the temperature at the top surface, maximum temperature 500, but as it is going, as the thickness or the depth of this block is increasing, the temperature is gradually decreasing until it becomes 100 degrees on the bottom as well as 100 degrees on the sides of the block. So this is how you can save this one, solve this problem. So you can now click on save DB and go to file, say exit and save everything, press OK.